22 people killed in a nasty accident on the Gulu Highway in Kiriandongo District. Three injured as fire guts Mary Stewart phone at Kerry University. And two suspected bombs found in the ceiling of a building along Kampala Road. Traders flee with their lives.
From Ripped by Ink 256.
You're jamming with
DJ.
Perfection is a norm.
The show. My name is Victoria Namtebi Luwaga. Hi, Exile.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for waiting and thank you for having me.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So why DJing in particular?
Long story. Yeah. But it's always the things you love that you go for.
Oh, so
and
you
this
love
is one
DJing.
Of the things. Music generally. Because it never occurred to me that it was DJing, it was the love for music.
Okay.
Yeah.
And which genre in particular?
Rock and roll, pop to the top. But yeah, I play what people like, not more what I like. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. All right. So we're going to be getting more up close and personal with DJ XZYL on the show. All you've got to do is to go to our social media pages at Urban TV Ghana on Twitter, Urban Television on Facebook, and rate her anchoring skills from a scale of 1 to 10. Also, ask her those questions that you want her to answer tonight. She'll be answering them. But for now, you ready?
Yeah.
To read the news?
Well, ooh, let's see. I've always wanted to be a news anchor. Maybe
really?
This is my chance to win.
All right, let's go.
All right, now. 22 people have been confirmed dead in a nasty accident that took place in Kiriandongo on Friday evening. 14 sustained grave injuries and are currently admitted at Kirandongo and Mulago Hospital. The accident occurred at around 8 p.m. when a Gaga bus from Lira rammed into a moving tractor that had no lights and reflectors. Here is more.
According to police spokesperson Emilian Kaima, Gaga bus registration number UAK562L rammed into a tractor registration number UAU872M and hit it badly, rolled and hit another beer truck registration number UAT088J, killing 19 people in total, 3 juveniles and 16 are adults. The regional police spokesperson for Albertine Region, Alan Julius Hakiza, who visited the scene of the accident today with the regional traffic officer Irene Chilengat and regional police commander Deo Obura 4 hours later, said the tractor driver is to blame for the accident, even though the bus driver was over speeding.
And I call upon all road users to observe the road safety and ensure that overspeeding on road is contained, said that lives are saved and people don't die just like that.
The bodies were retrieved from the wreckage of the three vehicles and taken to Chirandongo Hospital. All the three drivers were among those who died at the scene. The 14 people hospitalized in Chirandongo Hospital include Joel Waswa, Chintu Majid, Auma Gloria, Joshua Amonga, David Mutebi, Tenga Joshua, Okelo Santos, Nuwanji Caleb, Robson Okelo with head injury, 21-year-old Lauren Amoni, a third-year law student at Makerere University, sustained fractures on both arms, Simon Ojok, a 26-year-old staff of UNHCR working at Chaka refugee camp, sustained fracture on the arm and head injury. He was also complaining of severe stomach pain. Jackie Apio, a staff at Lira Regional Referral Hospital, was in coma, and her son, 8-year-old Nathan, sustained head injury and was in critical condition, while another 7-year-old Norman breathed his last at the hospital. 25-year-old Joshua Agonya, who sat at the front seat, is in critical condition. His aunt, Mole Akelo, who is taking care of him, wondered how God protected him when most of those who were seated in the rear seats died. Another victim, 27-year-old Jackson Agona, a laboratory technician, sustained a compound fracture on both legs and both arms and was in critical condition on oxygen. By press time, Jackson Agona was being transferred to Nsambia Hospital. Caretakers said only intern doctors were available at the hospital. Lango Parliamentary Group Chairperson Felix Okot Ogong sent his condolence to the people of Lango for the tragic incident. A military chopper evacuated other injured persons to Mulago Hospital for further treatment. Lands Minister Betty Amongi said she coordinated with the UPDF to airlift the injured to Kampala. She called on the relatives to be calm and said government is doing everything to make sure those injured are treated. In just a period of 2 weeks, 3 nasty accidents have occurred on the Gulu Highway, killing 32 people in total. 2 happened in Chirandongo and another in Oyam. This report was filed by Hudson Apunyo for Urban TV.
Well, thank you, Hudson Apunyo, for that report. And may the souls of the deceased rest in eternal peace. And may God strengthen the family of those that lost their loved ones. In other news, 3 students have sustained injuries as they tried to escape the early morning fire which gutted Mary Stewart Hall at Makerere University. By press time, the cause of the fire had not yet been established, though police tasked the university management to put in place precautionary measures such as fire extinguishers. We have details in this report.
According to the hall residents, the fire started at around 5 a.m. from a canteen on the first floor of the 14-story building as majority of the students were still asleep. What woke them up was the too much heat and smoke, making students who were in shock jump off the upper floors.
I had a lot of heat in my room, and when I woke up, there was smoke in my room. So I woke up my roommate and we opened the window, we tried to peep outside, but the smoke was much. So we opened up the door to see in the corridors. The corridor was full of smoke. So me, I just ran down and I found a fire had just started. We're sleeping for a few minutes past five. And then I woke up from sleep feeling there was someone with me. And then like I heard people moving, shouting. So me, I thought people were joking. But then to realize they were saying fire.
Because you're in a trying situation, everything is going bad. Good enough, we didn't lose anything.
By the time the police fire brigade came in, the students were still trying to put out the fire, which destroyed a number of properties, though they finally managed to put it off. Police have launched investigations into the matter to find out what sparked off this fire.
Investigations are ongoing to ascertain what could be the cause of the fire, but we want to thank the good people of the university who called us very fast, who responded swiftly. We managed to extinguish the fire, although three students got minor burns. They are now currently in hospital in education, but not in bad condition.
Police, backed up by Kampala Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago and other university political leaders, have put to task the university management to put in place precautionary measures such as fire extinguishers at the university halls of residence.
We really want to call upon the public to implement fire extinguishers, put them in place.
We really need the action that would be taken by the university administration and the government to assist these students, because this unfortunate incident was really foreseen. They should have taken precautionary measures.
And we hope finally the government is going forward. And we hope finally the administration is going forward. Yes. And we hope the investigations are really going to be carried out thoroughly. We cannot take this lightly.
Mary Stewart is one of the largest female halls at Makerere University, but unfortunately it lacks fire extinguishers, which put students at a bigger risk in case of such tragedies. This report was filed by Jaliat Namwaya for Urban TV.
After two suspected bombs were discovered in the ceiling of a building along Kabbala Road. Police has, however, confirmed that these were not explosives, though investigations are still ongoing into the matter. We have details on this report.
These two metallic pieces, which looked like bombs to the traders, were discovered in the ceiling of one of the buildings along Kampala Road by the contractors who were carrying out renovations. This bomb scare made traders scamper for safety, something which left business along Kampala Road paralyzed. Bomb experts, however, intervened in time and cordoned off the area to carry out a thorough search. Police confirmed that it was not an explosive and commended the public for vigilance.
And take note of anything they, that looks to be suspicious in their area. They are known to engage it because you never know. So we thank the people who are too vigilant and informed us in time to make sure that we take all this. We shall inform you what exactly their make is with due time.
This report was filed by Jaliat Namoya for Urban TV.
Thank you, Jaliat, for that report. Now, youth from the Archdiocese of Tororo have led other Christian faithful in the matter's walk of faith from Munyonyo up to St. Matia Mulumba at Old Kampala. This walk trailed the matters as they walked to Namgongo for their persecution. The Archbishop of Tororo, His Grace Dr. Emmanuel Obo, was the main celebrant at the special mass, which was the climax of the walk of faith, attended by, among others, the Minister of Tourism, Professor Ephraim Kamuntu.
Your grace, you have just traveled into the footsteps of the Uganda martyrs as they were traveling to Namgongo. And at this very place where you are seated right now, there was a stopover. And one of the martyrs, Matthias Mulumba, was brutally killed.
We must always turn to God. Therefore, the matters have taught us how to turn to God, even in joy or in suffering, in sickness or in good health.
By definition, if you stay out of your house for more than 2 hours, which is not normal, already you are defined as a tourist. So, all those who came from Tororo today, by definition, you are tourists.
A group of over 700 pilgrims from the Archdiocese of Tororo in the district of Mali, Sironko and Manafa started their journey to Namgongo on foot yesterday. The pilgrims from the various parishes that include Sironko, Muyembe, Budadiri, Nyondo and Situmi, among others, converged at St. Denis Catholic Church in Namatala, where they were flagged off. Here is an in-depth on the story.
I think I'm the one.
In their joyful mood, chanting songs of praise, the pilgrims paid respect to the sculpture of St. Denis Sebugwao that stands at the entry of St. Denis Catholic Church in Namatala. Some of them do it by praying, while others do it by singing, before entering the church to kneel at the altar to pray for the journey. It's at this point that the pilgrims have their first refreshments and bathing as they prepare for Mass. One of the pilgrims, 56-year-old Phyllis Kainza, said that this is her fourth year of trekking to Namugongo. Kainza said she has gained a lot from these treks, citing her prayers for her last-born son to have children, and he had twins, all boys. The team leader for Sironko Parish, Zita Wambasu, said that this trekking is a sign of self-punishment for the sins committed. She said they are happy that their diocese is the one hosting the function after 20 years. Herbert Musamali explains that they are going to do their walking at night to avoid getting tired. He explained that they are expecting to reach Namugongo by 1st of June. The second team of over 1,000 pilgrims, including Kenyans, was set off this morning at St. Denis Catholic Church. This report was filed by Wilfred Masaba for Urban TV.
Well, you're watching PM Live Celebrity Edition, and in the house today, we're with the baddest female DJ, Deejay XZYL. How are you finding the challenge of reading the news?
I wish people would just give me feedback, because I don't know.
Yes, I'd like to read to you.
It's like I'm auditioning for a job, and maybe I got the job, maybe I didn't.
I'm
waiting for the person to tell me. Did you get it?
Okay, if management called you to read the news, would you do it based on your experience today?
I'll ask for some more time to put myself together, because I carry a smile everywhere. It's so hard, like sometimes you have to read a very sad story and then you have to put on a sad face. But for me, sometimes it's so hard. Even when I'm sad, I'm still like, okay, I'm sad, but okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let's get back to DJing. So did you do a course in DJing? Did you just wake up and start DJing?
I wouldn't say I just woke up and started DJing. I started with Platinum DJs. Okay. That was training me how to use the apparel and all that. Mm-hmm. And I kind of, you know, you don't just go into it when you don't know anything. I kind of had the idea about the music, mm-hmm. so I needed to know the skill on how to operate what.
Okay.
And I did not even think that it would turn into a profession, honestly.
Oh.
Yeah.
So is there any other professional course you did?
After that?
No, like, okay, you went to school.
Oh, which course did you do? Ooh, I'm a reader. I did aviation. I did BBA. So, yeah. I'm a reader.
So, a BBA graduate is DJing.
Yeah, yeah. I know.
I like that. So, how do you find the DJing industry?
The competition is tight. Mm-hmm. These days, people have got games. So, you have to be creative. Otherwise, anyone can get the machines and just play music. Mm-hmm. It's, for some people, it's just playing two songs together. So, anyone can do that. But how much skill you put into it, how much time you... You know there is no time, honestly, because some of us do a normal job. Is it 8 to 5?
Uh-huh.
I know, what Mr. Ripper does that, but still he invests himself into doing that. So personally, I also do the same. I find the little time that I can to be creative with the little that I know. So that, when I get out there, I can also be able to challenge the people who have a lot of time to be DJs but don't really put in the time for it.
All right.
But it's challenging.
It's challenging.
Especially for the chicks. For the women, rather.
Okay.
What, yeah.
But you're a chick.
Yeah, you know, when they see us, what is she going to do that he couldn't do?
Yet you beat them, actually. I saw you were the second best DJ in UG.
That was the first.
The first?
It's the best.
First is female.
Yes. Yeah. Even if it was Mel, bring him on and show him what this game is all about.
All right, I'm loving the vibe here. Go to our social media pages at Urban TV on Twitter, Urban Television on Facebook, and rate our celebrity anchor, Deejay XZYL, from a scale of 1 to 10. Also, ask her those questions that you want her to answer tonight, whether she's searching or single, or how she manages her relationship and the DJing at night. Just post on our social media pages at Urban TV Ghana, Twitter, Urban Television, Facebook. And for now, we sample the mix, my job.
Jingle up your body, jingle up your sing sing.
Fat, give me some of that. Loving all your booty back when the beat drop for me, my baby, we are treated. She gon' make you move to Miami. She move it like a gypsy. Your body got me tipsy. I should take a step back, fall back. This girl got me feeling risky. She ready for the taking, and I got the motivation. Cause when you see your dance, there's a chance you might not come home from vacation.
And if you look, you fall in love. She got that ass, she make it click. She leave you shook, and now you hooked. The way she dance,
she gon' make you move to Miami. She gon' make you move to Miami. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we gon' party. Freaking every weekend, baby, we just getting started. Y síguete moviendo, que todo te están viendo. Damn, you got me, girl, that body's built like a Bugatti.
And if you look, you fall in love. She got that ass, she make it clear. She leave you shook, and now you hook. The way she dance,
she gon' make you move to Miami. She gon' make you move to Miami.
Come on, pam pam, jiggle up your bam bam. When you're ready for the cool, cool, cool.